I've been thinking a lot about money and material lately. As is the case with most of you, I grew up in a culture obsessed with hoarding money and material, beyond necessity. The more, the better. And if you don't have much, then you simply aren't successful in life, even if you are happy. More clothes, more makeup, more toys, more stuff, more digits on a screen. This mindless pursuit was programmed into me from a young age. Before I adopted the minimalist lifestyle, I spent most of my 20s trying to gather as many digits as possible. Why? Because I had a lot of wants. I wanted a nice unit to rent in an upmarket location filled with trendy new furniture. I wanted the latest computer and iPhone. I wanted expensive, fashionable clothing, and lots of it. I wanted a fancy car, makeup, beauty treatments, money for party drugs, alcohol, restaurant visits, upmarket gym membership, and expensive holidays. Endless wants. But I didn't really want any of these things. I wanted the feelings I was promised, the feelings I was programmed to believe they would bring. I wanted to be liked by others. I wanted to be loved by someone. But most of all, I just wanted to be happy. And as cliche as it might sound, the more money and stuff I accumulated, the less happy I actually became. Then one day I woke up and realized that money actually means very little to my happiness. Sure, it's necessary to have our basic needs covered, and unfortunately, some money is required for that in this current structure. But beyond that, it's pretty useless. Am I saying money is bad or the root of all evil? No. It's really just another form of energy that we have collectively chosen to give value to. It's our individual attitude towards money which matters. The problem is many of us give money and material far too much value in our lives, and then it begins to own us. We get so caught up in getting rich that we forget the true meaning of life. Lately, my goal has been to live on as little money as possible, to spend my time creating a future that is low maintenance rather than fully dependent on the monetary system, to have more real life experiences, to sweat, to feel, to hurt, to adventure, rather than strive to be as comfortable as possible. Life really does begin at the end of your comfort zone. I aim to create a lifestyle that is fulfilling and stable long term, not fragile like our financial system and filled with the fleeting highs and desperate lows of the material world. My wants have now mostly changed to needs. What do I really need in this world to be happy? Do I need that extra clothing? Do I need the latest iPhone? Do I need that beauty treatment? Do I need to buy that, or can I actually make that myself? That's where the DIY life fits perfectly. I can spend my time developing a valuable life skill and making something myself, rather than buying it and perpetuating that cycle of consumption. We are a culture that is promised instant gratification if we have the cash. Personal responsibility is a thing of the past. You can now have years of fat accumulation sucked out of your stomach in an hour, rather than earn your results through years of dedicated healthy diet and lifestyle. You can pop down the store and instantly buy your meat meals plastic wrapped and blood free, rather than kill the animal yourself. We have a big problem, and I no longer feel comfortable supporting the industries that thrive on lies and deception. We vote with our dollar. This is a big part of why we are creating a fruit forest. This forest will feed us for free in the future. We also strive to trade fruits and services with neighbours. You too can do this. You can create a food forest for yourself on as little as a quarter of an acre. Consider renting a property that allows you freedom to plant or get involved in a community garden. You don't even need to buy the property. You can be a caretaker who lives on the property and maintains it. If you don't have land of your own, you can do guerrilla planting where you plant fruit seeds in a forest somewhere, and eventually you will have fruit. With a little bit of research and effort, you can even have some free food growing in your unit. You can have a mini fruit forest because there are certain fruit trees that actually grow well in pots. A fruit tree may take some years to bear fruit, but as a Chinese proverb says, the best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago. The second best time is now. Some people are so poor, all they have is money. Don't become one of those people. Take a moment now to relax and meditate by this beautiful jungle creek with me. Forget about the pressure you feel around money and the future. You are complete as you are.